Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Look to Cassiopeia, a medium-sized M-shape composed of several second and third magnitude stars, high overhead to the north in the evening hours. These five stars have quite the distance differences, too. We just happen to be in the right spot where they form an M-shape from our perspective, or W, depending on the time of year and the tilt of your head. Between Shadir and Gamma is a 3.5 magnitude star, somewhat closer to Shadir. It should be visible naked eye from most locations. Train a telescope this way, though, and push up the magnification a bit to separate the 11 arcseconds apart components of Eta Cassiopeiae. Other than the subtle color difference, what's so interesting here? Well, the primary star is very much like our Sun. Eta Cass is also G spectral class, and contains 97% of the Sun's mass, and is 101% of its radius. Plus, it's only 19.4 light-years away, basically in our stellar backyard. That makes it a lot like our Sun's twin, right? Well, not quite. More on that in a moment. And now this week's dark sky fact. A fellow amateur astronomer on Reddit wrote to me saying, "I called the city, contacted a councilwoman, and finally the utility about a streetlight. I emphasized sleep and power consumption and the primary reasons for the request. Great news, the utility just put up a shield. Get involved. You can make a difference too." The primary of Eta Cassiopeiae is what is called a metal poor star, meaning it is low in elements other than hydrogen or helium. Due to that, it likely doesn't have planets, as most stars we've found with planets have higher metals content. But if there were planets there, then the smaller K-class dwarf star that orbits it every 480 years that we see as the secondary would appear as bright as five full moons in the sky of an Earth 2 planet. We can admire the color difference of these two stars from here on Earth and remember that the light leaving them was sent 19.4 years ago, touching our retinas only today. Another double star well worth pursuing that's somewhat out of the way is Struve 3053. Starting at Gamma, look for where Kappa Cassiopeiae is and, centering that star, prepare to hop to the other side of the finder's field of view. But note how this 4.8 magnitude star next to Gamma is just off that line? Follow that line more closely, but estimating double the distance from Kappa. That will place you at this little grouping of a half dozen or so 6th and 7th magnitude stars. The one closest to Cassiopeia's M-shape, this one, is Struve 3053, and it's a lovely double star that's also a binary system. At over 2,000 light-years distance from us, though, their distance apart is considerable, around 1/7 of a light-year. But to us, visually, the color contrast is what is so pretty to see, and worth seeking out in this somewhat off-the-beaten-path location. Again, like our Sun, it has a G-class primary and is similar in mass, while the A-class secondary is rather small, but much hotter at 9,000 Kelvin. You should see a lovely contrast between these two stars, though actual color perceptions of them vary by observer. Looking for more colorful doubles in Cassiopeia? How about binoculars visible WZ Cassiopeiae, found less than 2 degrees away from CAF? Finder charts and more info on finding these and more double stars in Cassiopeia will be at the homepage of eyesinthesky.com this week. Jupiter has begun retrograde motion in Gemini and sits well above the horizon for good observing now by 11 p.m. At high magnification late in the evening, Venus sports a lovely just under half-crescent moon shape. On the morning side, Comet Ison will be within a few degrees of Porima on the 12th and 13th, headed towards Spica on the 17th and 18th. Check out all the other comets Eyes on the Sky highlighted last week, too. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.